Who doesn't dream of living by the ocean? See, that's the problem. We love our coast too much. We used to think of them as dangerous, but now we see them as idyllic. We want to build as close to the water as possible, but in doing so, we're destroying natural ecosystems like marshes, mangroves, and coral reefs. This destruction not only harms the environment, but also puts us at greater risk from coastal flooding, as it destroys our first line of coastal defense. Hello, I'm Mike Beck, professor and AXA Chair in Coastal Resilience and director of the Center for Coastal Climate Resilience at the University of California, Santa Cruz. Let's dive into some facts and figures. Coastal habitats, such as wetlands and reefs, are being lost rapidly. We've lost over 20% of the world's mangroves in just the last four decades. And the Earth has lost approximately half of its living coral cover since the 1870s. Indeed, more than half of the Great Barrier Reef was degraded by bleaching in 2020 alone. But it's not just coral reefs, it's also oyster reefs that used to line our coastlines, for example, across the US and Europe. But we've totally forgotten about the reefs that they used to create. And today, we've lost more than 85% of them. The loss of coastal habitats is driven by coastal development, overfishing, and pollution. And climate change is now adding to that destruction, as wetlands are challenged by rising seas and increasing waves, and reefs are challenged by increasing temperature and acidity. This is especially troubling because coastal habitats serve as that critical first line of defense, and their loss puts communities at even greater risk from coastal flooding. So what's the great power of coastal habitats? Well, corals and other reefs work as natural breakwaters, and they reduce flooding by breaking waves offshore. And as for wetlands, such as marshes and mangroves, well, they protect coastlines by dampening storm surge and waves, and they also prevent erosion and can even build new land. Unfortunately, funds dedicated to environmental conservation, including for habitat restoration, are very limited compared to the funding for hazard mitigation, climate adaptation, and storm recovery. We need to figure out how to show that nature can and should be part of the solution for protecting our communities so that we can invest in these nature-based solutions instead. This is my surf beach at home on January 5th, 2023. Normally, there's a lovely little beach, nice waves, and a small lagoon on the backside. But January 5th was the worst day of waves and storm damage that we've seen in decades, maybe ever, in Central California. Across town, waves smashed into roads, homes, and businesses. And that includes my beach. It includes areas like Capitola, where we lost the pier and many of the coastal businesses right at the shore. And Seacliff, where the campsites and the road leading to them were completely destroyed. But it's not just in California. 2020 was a record year for storms in the North Atlantic and Caribbean, with more named storms than ever before, 30. Indeed, we ran out of our typical alphabet names and had to resort to Greek letters, culminating ultimately in Hurricane Iota. There is some good news about storms. Deaths are decreasing, largely because we're much better at predicting and providing early warning. The bad news, however, is that the costs are rising. In 2020, reinsurers estimated that natural disasters worldwide produced losses greater than $210 billion, with insured losses greater than $80 billion. Scientists predict that climate change will make these storms even more intense, with a likely increase in the proportion of storms that reach categories 4 and 5. Are most intense. Now, most people think that sea level rise is the main problem caused by climate change. But there's a much greater problem for our coastal infrastructure. Waves are rising too, and this is far more concerning for us right now. The daily attack of waves on our coastal infrastructure is devastating. Wave after wave, minute after minute, day after day, degrading the life of coastal infrastructure, including bridges, ports, and seawalls, across hundreds of thousands of kilometers of coastline worldwide. We usually design this coastal infrastructure to last a half century or more, but that was for the wave climates of the past. Increasing wave energy means that those expensive infrastructures will now fail much, much earlier.